Hello, this is Mr. Techie and today I'm going to show you about the Logitech F710 gamepad. First, let us look at its features. It has 2.4 GHz wireless, broad game support, programmable controls and dual vibration motors. This is a very good joypad made by Logitech and it's a wireless joypad. It's got a nanometer over here in the joypad. The boxing is a little troubled, so I don't think this is going to be a problem. Let's unbox it. This should be easy. We'll be needing a scissors. Okay. That's it. Okay, this is really going to be tough. God. There it is, it's come out. Okay. So they've given us an extend cable, a CD, a few manuals, and last but not the least, the nano receiver. Better plug that out now. Kind of clumsy with these stuff. Almost out, and there you go. This is the Logitech Nano receiver. Now let's talk about the gamepad. The gamepad is really nice. It has two analog sticks, one D-pad, a mode button. When this mode button is activated, the controls from the analog stick get interchanged with the controls with the D-pad. So if you're playing GTA, then you have to move with this. But then if you activate the mode button, you'll start moving with the D-pad. Okay, so analog sticks, which can, and D-pad, a mode button, vibration, back, start, A, B, X, Y, left button, right button, left trigger, right trigger, and this helps you to change the Xbox mode from the direct to Xbox. They gave us two Duracell batteries. We need to put AA batteries, rechargeable will be better, and this is the nano receiver, place to put the nano receiver. You can just put it in here and carry it wherever you go, I would suggest you to play games with the Xbox mode, because that is really useful. It gives you better feel. And so let us start using the computer with this and check out. First, we're going to install the software. Let's do it. Okay. It's simple. You just have to open this up. No. Put the CD inside and close it. I own the previous version of this joypad. I own the wired version, but this one's wire is kind of screwed up. So that is why I bought the new one. The wireless one is 1,000 times better, trust me. There you go. The setup has come. Click on run setup. Max Payne, my favorite game. There. Yes. Okay, now the setup will start. Next, I accept. Next. Now it's going to start the installation.
You can keep your joypad ready with you because it's going to ask you to plug in your joypad. So take your joypad, put it in Xbox mode, open it up, keep the nano receiver ready with you, and plug this out. That's it. This light is going to blink when you switch it on, and then you have to click the mode button twice. That's it. Okay, the software is installing. This should be ready with you. It's taking a little time. There you go. Now it is going to ask you to plug in your device. Just a few more moments. That's it. Now you'll have to plug in your device. Take this, just plug it in here, or I would advise you to plug it into an extender, you know, plug it into the extender, leave it, installing device software, click on next. Your device is ready to use. That's it. This is done. It's almost over. Till then, you better open your control panel. Where is it? Where is the control panel? Oh yeah, there it is. Open up your control panel. View devices and printers. This should be an option here. Okay. Still going to take some time. This is it, the wireless gamepad, properties, hardware, Xbox 360 controller, details, general, change settings, okay, close it, let's go back to the installation, okay, next, finish, and then the readme will appear, that's it, just close it off. Crap. Finish. Done. That's it. You're done. Within the Logitech profile. Retry. Okay, what the hell is this? Oh, yes. You have to click the middle Logitech button to start the thing. So then your gamepad is ready. Here, the wireless gamepad. You'll have to configure it. So, properties and general. Okay, fine. Okay, yeah, game controller settings, this is it. Then properties here, like you'll have to configure your gamepad through this 3, 4. You can check everything, you know, press all the buttons, press everything, check it. It's really useful because when you start the joypad, you can come to know whether it's working or not. I bought this online, so I really want to know if it actually works, so that is why. And you can even check the D-pad, see that? Okay, that's it. It's working well. Thank you for watching my video. I'll be back with more videos soon. Till then, enjoy. Bye-bye.